Thank you. We are back to the March 10th County Commissioners meeting on recess. Next on the agenda at 11:30 is the Commissioner Community Update. Franklin, what'd you do this week?
I went around all through the corporate valley, other places, and then on the roads, and then also on those three, or however meetings we had. DES had every morning there.
All right, Elaine.
Lots of drinking meetings. There was one day that I wasn't at the courthouse last week.
Yeah, it's a busy week.
And then I also was touring to see in my district over the votes. And I don't think we got it as bad as they did towards the south end of the county. But we got it plenty well bad, including my own district. So. And I just, again, have to say hats off to those guys that have worked so hard. Whether it be the fire department or sheriff's office, the road, Mike with his DES stuff. They've been badass.
Yeah.
So that was my week.
Mine was the same. It was wet. Search and rescue also was the road closed signs Thursday night. Those were manned by people.
Right.
And that was search and rescue that did that. So we had an awful lot of people that just gave up their time last week and all this stuff that was going on.
I think fire department was manning some of those sites too.
Yes, they were. And dealing with pumping out basements and helping people find alternative places to stay who needed it. Yeah, they were amazing.
We're very lucky to have those people.
Yeah.
Very, very lucky. And that might be the case in every county, but I just feel really blessed that they're in ours.
Mm-hmm. I agree. Mike and I went on a tour Thursday all day of the flooding. We hit the south end, Crow Creek Valley, well, not the Crow Creek Valley as much as the area just kind of around that. It was amazing. Raidersburg wasn't all that wet. I mean, it was muddy, but they didn't have nearly the issues that the surrounding area did. Shelley Lane, of course, we lost the canal right above that. When we saw it, it was a waterfall coming down about 25 feet wide. Yeah, it was incredible. There were waterfalls over the Tostin Dam, which that's the first time those guys have seen that.
In 25 years.
Yeah. Yeah, just spectacular in a very negative sense of the word is what I saw. I saw Tostin Dam Road with roofs cut in it that were 2-3 feet deep from the flooding. One road, Muddy Lane, the water was so high that you could see about 6 inches of a fence post on the other side of the road. We did not cross that road. it was an amazing day. 6 mile sheet flooding up there. Just things that, you know, people all over the place were saying, we have never seen it like this. People who grew up in those neighborhoods. And then the next day, of course, the silos was hit hard. Sunday, I saw Mike driving around some more. Spruce Grove was hit hard. Ambulance couldn't get up one of the roads, the private road in Lazy H.M.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was too muddy. So a lot of
they got the person out then.
They contacted the fire department, who was able to get a bit further than the ambulance. Mm-hmm. They called the folks who actually brought the person to them. Fire department then took it to the ambulance. The ambulance then went to St. Pete's. So everything was fine. It was not as serious as they originally thought, so thank goodness nobody was.
They originally thought it was a heart attack.
Yeah. Yeah. So one thing I saw on my tour with Mike was a lot of people with shovels doing what they could to protect their own roads and their neighbors standing right with them. So it was heartwarming in that sense to see that. An awful lot of kudos were going out to the volunteers, to the road crew. The road crew prior to the flooding had worked 10 to 12 hours overtime Friday, Saturday, and Sunday before. So they've had quite a few hours of overtime, quite a few quite a few sleepless nights with everything they've been doing, so that needs to be stated. We did have the debriefings, and that was quite a week. Moving on to next week and looking ahead, Board of Crime Control will meet on Friday. We have an all-day meeting. I represent local government. I did speak a little bit and get some input at MACO from the Justice and Public Safety Committee. But if you guys have anything you want me to bring forward, I certainly will. Just let me know this week. We meet again on Friday, so I will be gone from here and chairing that board. And that's it for me. So, anything else? All right. We have COS possibly in 2 minutes. Elaine, we have two claims here. Tom Budowitz for Rolling Glen Ranch work. We were sued years ago by Rolling Glen Ranch Subdivision. Tom Budowitz represented the county in that. We won, and now every single lot that's sold, a portion of that comes back to the county to help pay for expenses like building the road and improvements to county roads that will be used by the citizens in that subdivision. And then the other one we have is just a water sewer garbage bill for extension. And if you would sign those, I would be more than happy to initial them. And then we'll put them in the claims process.
I'm surprised that one of those Rolling Glen Ranch lots sold.
Actually, we didn't sell. A number of them sold. I think there were 7 or 8, weren't there?
There's a number of them been sold. There's still some of them out there.
Yeah, this one doesn't say. We got a letter that had, I can't give you the exact number, but around 9, give or take. So hopefully that will continue. Yes,
Madam Chair, what is there a percentage from each of the lots, or how do they determine how much is given back to the county when the lots are sold?
Absolutely. Thanks, Ann.
According to the agreement, each lot, I believe, has a lien against it for $5,270.
Okay.
I think that's how much it is.
Which is about the same number that was invited in last week's meeting.
Right, for that one that was
5260 or something.
Yeah.
Like that.
All right, anything else for the good of the order? Any public comment?
I've got a question. Bill Garwood. Madam Chair, the ambulances, are they four-wheel drive? Probably said that they are.
They are not.
One
is. One is four-wheel drive, one is not. The issue was, the understanding of the crew was, LH Bomb Road is a flat road, which most of it is. They didn't realize that the call was somebody who lived at the top of it. So
okay.
They took out the two-wheel drive. But the fire crew had four-wheel drive and still couldn't get up it.
Okay.
So
I was going to say, I happen to have inside knowledge of a company in Pennsylvania that they have been taking in ambulances from all over the country and making them four-wheel drive.
Oh.
Yeah, and it's a big business. I didn't think it would be but vans, ambulances, something like that. So if they would be interested, I know something.
Excellent. You know what? I will pass that along to the crew.
Okay.
Excellent. Good information.
Okay.
Any other public comment? Public comments? Public comment. All right. Nothing more for the good of the order? Last going once, going twice? Meeting is adjourned. Thank you, everyone.
You know, I have to say, Trudy was a real trooper with us all
yeah.
weekend long.
Oh. Yeah, Mike brings donuts, so it's kind of an easy meeting to go to. And they last, what, about half an hour? I think is all we were in there. So.
I had a list of who all was of emergency services. Yeah.